Some of the world's greatest conquerors. You know, I'm a history major, yes, so sir. I know that stuff. I spent a lot of time watching the History Channel.
Jesus.
And tons of books. Something about it always fascinates me. But some of the world's greatest conquerors, they had to go through many conflicts.
Yeah.
And in these conquerors, they always had key ingredients. Man, if you look at Alexander the Great, he was one of the greatest conquerors. He ruled the Greek kingdom of Macedon. He conquered most of the known world. And he was known, and he got his start because he was able to subdue a horse, a stallion that nobody else could ride. Everybody else that tried to get on the stallion would throw him off and it would devour their flesh. But he was able to subdue the stallion. And he rode the stallion every day into battle until the day of his death.
Jesus.
To be a conqueror, you got to be able to go through something.
My Lord!
The road ain't going to be easy.
That's right.
Because it wouldn't be conquered.
That's right.
It'd be given to you. Alexander the Great, he was such a great general. He paved the way for your Julius Caesars and your Marcus Aurelius. They were the great emperors of the Roman Empire. We know how Rome was. Rome was continuing to expand. Conquered most of the, it was over the most of the known world.
Jesus.
Then one of my favorites is the General Hannibal.
Oh yeah.
He was a Carthaginian. And one of the feats that he was known for doing is that he marched an army of elephants through the Atlas Mountains.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
That is no small task.
No, sir.
But it speaks to the character of somebody that was leading the expedition. Can you imagine many people that spoke against him and they said, no, that's impossible.
Yeah.
It may seem impossible, but if you got the fortitude to be able to press through what might amount of opposition, you can do the impossible.
Amen.
I can imagine the look on his enemies' faces. When he crosses a barrier that nobody didn't expect him to cross.
Amen.
Not only did he cross the barrier, but he crossed the barrier with an army of war elephants.
Wow.
Anybody ever seen an elephant?
Mm-hmm.
Mighty, big, big individuals. But I said that to say this, to be a conqueror. The Bible says we are more than a conqueror.
Amen.
You got to be willing to go through obstacles. You got to be willing to go through when the times are tough. Huh? You got to be willing to go through when you go through places that you seem like you shouldn't get there. But because God is with you, because God has commissioned you, that's why you're more than a conqueror.
Yeah,
God has given you strength to overdo all things. Because when Jesus rose from the grave, he said, all power is given unto me. There's no power greater than God. As the pastor said, if God be for us,
yeah.
If God be for me, who can defeat me? I'm more than a conqueror.
Amen.
Sometimes you got to encourage yourself.
That's right.
My God, the battle looks rough sometimes. When the devil realizes that you are a child of God, that you got purpose on your life, he gonna fight you. He gonna fight you tooth and nail. He wanna take the fight out of you. But do I got any conquerors in the house today? Out of all these generals, they had one key characteristic. They were willing to move forward.
My Lord.
Mm-hmm. Look at somebody and say, forward.
Forward.
You can't conquer none if you ain't moving forward. You got to move forward.
Forward.
You can't stay in place. You got to pursue. You got to move forward. By staying still, you're complacent. You have to move forward.
Yes.
Christianity was made to be a progressive thing. It was never made to be in one place. Because we know that when God chose the 12 apostles, and then how they stayed in Jerusalem, but God told them to preach the gospel into all of the world. And what God had to send persecution to scatter them to make you move forward. You got to move forward. Sometimes we don't want to move forward because the road looks rough. But you got to have the mind. I am more than a conqueror. I don't care how high the mountain is. I don't care how low the valley is. If God is for me, who can be against me?
Amen.
That's right.
You must continue to expand.
My Lord.
As a Christian, you must grow daily. You should grow stronger in your walk with God. You must have a stronger prayer life.
Amen.
Your prayer life should not be the same as it was 5 years ago.
Amen.
You should know more scripture than you knew 5 years ago.
Amen.
If you were in a class for 2 years, they're going to look at you like you're retarded. Sooner or later, you got to advance. Look to your left and look to your right and say, have you advanced today? You got to advance. You got to look at yourself and see that I have grown. I have grown in the Lord. These things used to bother me, but they don't bother me no more because I'm advancing. One time, this thing used to bother me, but I have conquered it because God said, I am the head.
Amen.
One thing I learned, everybody ain't gonna pat you on the back. You might think that, but everybody ain't gonna pat you on the back. You got to encourage yourself. You got to say, I'm greater than, because God is on the inside. I shall not fear what man is doing. God is in control. If you're gonna be in the fire, God is in the fire. Oh God, I believe God. Be like the people you need more. God, you put me in the fire. My demise, but God will bring me out.
Amen.
Bring me out every time.
Amen.
When you learn to believe the word of God, it transforms you.
Yes, sir.
You become a bold individual.
Yes.
Because you begin to learn it ain't dependent upon me. It ain't dependent on my knowledge. It ain't dependent upon my intellect. As a pastor said, yeah, I've been to college. I rub my head against scholars. I graduated with honor, but it ain't about that. That ain't what's gonna make me prosper. It ain't about the power of God. The Lord is my life and my salvation. Who shall I fear? Who shall I be afraid?
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Spirit's taught me not to trust in those things.
Come on, son.
Spirit told me not to trust in my wealth, because you don't have it today. It'll be gone tomorrow. Oh God, haven't God ever brought you in a breaking place where he had to break you down and let you know that it ain't about you. It's all about me. You rise and you fall according to my will. God will take that thing that you was trusting in. He'll take it away from you and let you trust in him.
Gone.
The world. Credit up one day, gone the next.
Yeah. Yeah.
Amen.
What the world? We as men, we both sometimes.
Yes.
Yeah, I got good credit.
Yeah, yeah.
I got good credit.
That's right.
I got a couple thousand in the bank.
Yeah.
But I know how God is. When you start sticking your chest out, you start getting the glory. God bless you with a nice house. He bless you with a beautiful family.
Yeah.
He bless you with a nice car and a nice job. And you get full of yourself. Oh God, I got this job because I work hard. I got this job because I'm educated. Because I'm smart. I got this job because I got the right connection. But God, he can remove you. Just as he puts you there, he can remove you. Down. And I don't care what job you apply for, the answer is no. Because God said, I got to teach you something. Because you're too proud.
Amen.
And then, you know, after a while, everything you touch won't work. You got to realize God is fighting against you. He resisting you.
Amen.
He's fighting you. But in that process that he's fighting you, my God, a light bulb goes out. I'm fighting a battle that I cannot win. You learn to submit to God. God, I submit to your will. I repent of everything. I repent if I offended you. God, I can only make it by you. You've been transforming inside. You're getting some boldness now. See, one thing about it, you can't be no coward soldier, because you're fighting against the enemy that has already been to heaven. The worst thing we could ever do is underestimate the devil. You underestimate the devil, he's been the one you're trying to get to. But you got to condition yourself. The only thing that's going to build you up is the word of God. When you learn to trust in God, it transforms you. You become stronger. You become bolder. And the obstacles that used to dismay you, they don't dismay you no more. Because you realize, just as David said, when the lion rose up against me, God came in and I smote the lion. When the bear rose up, I smote the bear. So who is this giant? He'll fall just like the lion. He'll fall just like the bear. As you get experience in life, I learned that God is with me. He's with me. I don't care who against me, but God is with me. He brought me out of that situation.
Go ahead.
You don't want to fight. You don't want to fight. Stand with the Lord. Stand against the one that's undisputed. The one that's undefeated. He ain't never lost a battle. He never had a close strike.
Yes.
Oh God, that's the one who I
serve. Amen.
Go ahead.
My God. Stuff that used to make you quick. My God, you got bonus.
Yes, sir.
I see your trap, devil.
That's
see what
right.
You're doing. Right. But guess what? I ain't scared of you.
My
God.
Not one bit.
And my God, I am victorious. I'm walking in victory. I'm walking in the same victory that Christ has given to me. Oh, God, God has already gave me the victory. Look at somebody say, it's already done.
It's already done.
Already done. What you worrying about?
Go ahead,
Elder Lewis. God is already delivered.
You preach it. Hallelujah.
We serve the greatest conqueror.
Hallelujah.
My God has ever lived. He conquered death, hell, and the grave. Oh, God. That's the one I serve. I'm greater than Alexander the Great. I'm greater.
Thank you, Jesus.
My God, you should see yourself growing, advancing. You not growing, something wrong. My God, Chuck came from the hospital. We gave him some milk and the baby blew up. My goodness. Is that the same baby? He was growing. Because he was feeding. When you sit under the word of God, you grow. You expand.
Amen.
And as you grow, you go on what they call search and destroy. Look at somebody say search and destroy.
Search and destroy.
There was a lot of places. I heard a pastor preaching several Sundays ago when he said, if you lose ground, the enemy always take the ground. He don't leave no ground unoccupied. The devil want to fill your life with so much corruption.
Say it, son. Say it.
That you can't get back to God. So much distraction. So the more you draw away from God, the more ground the devil takes up. He starts filling you with all kinds of things. He'll give you the job desire. But what that job is not meant to bless you, it's meant to curse you. It's meant to pull you away from God. If this job don't let you go to church, if this job is interfering with you, we're praying with God, ain't up God. That's not the devil. You got to learn to speak to those things. Devil, this job look good on paper, but it's up the devil. And I rebuke you right now. Anything that draws you away from God is not of God.
That's right.
God wants to draw you to
close
him.
To him.
But what these things do, they'll choke out your prayer life.
Yes, they will.
They'll choke out. You can't study the Bible. You get infected with a python spirit. Well, it chokes out your prayer life.
Uh-huh.
You can't pray no more. Every time you get to read the Bible, you fall asleep. Something is fighting you.
That's right.
You're talking real.
Something fighting you.
Uh-huh.
You don't pray like you used to. You don't pray for the whole day. Don't even give God thanks. Only time you pray is when you come into the house on Sunday, something is wrong.
Amen.
That's right.
But when you've been transformed, it don't matter. I might have lost some ground in my life. I didn't do all things right. And then sometimes I backed up and the enemy backed me up into a corner. But that's all right. Where there's life, you still got a chance. I'm not dead. I'm still in the land of living. Oh God. But one day, God inspired me. God showed me all the ground that you done gave up to the enemy. He done gave it up. So what you gonna do about it? They had this thing. What they did in the Vietnam War called search and destroy. You got to seek out the enemy. You got to reclaim the ground that he has taken. You took it, but guess what? God done commissioned me, and I'm going to take it back.
Take it back.
I'm going to take it back. You done took my children, I'm going to take them back. You took my prayer life, I'm going to take it back. You took my passion, I'm going to take it back. I'm bold now. I ain't no power.
Amen.
I ain't no punk. God in the spot.
I got a big brother.
That's all.
You know, in school, that little brother got a big brother. He bold.
Yes, he is.
I got a brother in 12th grade. Yeah. He big till he play football. Guess what? You didn't mess with him either.
Amen.
Huh?
Pray the Lord.
We got God on our side.
That's
what are we afraid of?
Jesus.
Amen.
Set a trap for me.
Yeah.
I don't care.
Bye-bye.
You hang by your own gas.
Okay. Yeah.
I trust God, and I've seen it happen.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
You got to get your hand out of a situation and let God handle it.
Amen.
Look like a lie.
Hey.
Be willing to look like a lie. He did, yeah. Everybody, he did, yeah, he did.
That's right.
Truth never has to chase a lie.
No, it don't.
Let God fight your battles.
Amen.
And they had this thing where they search and destroy. They sought out the enemy. They go looking for him.
Huh?
My God, and then what they found out that the enemy had these strongholds. My God, they had this elaborate underground system. They couldn't figure out where the enemy was. The enemy would appear to the left, and they catch fire from the left, and they turn and do return fire. But then when they find out, when they go to the left, he has disappeared. What happened? You couldn't get him because you couldn't find him. To destroy someone, you got to find him. You got to find a stronghold. You got to find out wherever he's encamped at. A stronghold is a place where the enemy has fortified himself.
Amen.
Amen.
You got to find it before you can destroy it.
Jesus.
But when they found out that they had these underground tunnels, they developed these things called tunnel rats. They said, that's okay. We found where you're at, and we're going to send some down. Destroy you. You got to find the stronghold of the enemy where he's fighting. Have anybody been fought by the enemy? You can't figure out where it's coming from.
No,
Uh-huh.
Yes, sir. Amen.
That's right.
He got a stronghold. You don't know who he is.
Fight you.
Huh? What the world going on? Who fighting me? The enemy lies in camouflage. He wants to deceive you. And then you got to learn to have God open my eyes. Show me the devil. Show me that one that's fighting against me. It looked like he's my friend, but he's fighting me.
Uh-huh.
He's fighting me in the spirit. I can feel him. He think he's hidden. But what you know, when you seek God, God will reveal it to you.
Yes, it will.
God, when God reveals it to you, you got to search him out. And you got to just show him out. Because the Bible said, our weapons are mighty to God. Yes. To put it down of the stronghold.
You got to focus on that stronghold and you got to pull it down. Pull it down.
Amen.
Anybody ever seen a fort? My God, a fort ain't no small apparatus. It takes time to build up a fort. It took time for the enemy to build up the stronghold because it's a place that you have vacated and he have encamped himself. And that's why it's hard to bring him down because it's a fort. But everything that's been built, guess what? It can be brought down. You just got to have the determination to bring it down. You got to keep hitting. You got to keep bombarding. I know you behind that fort, Emma, and I'm going to bombard you with the word of God. Oh, God, you haven't kept nothing in my finances. But guess what? I'm going to bombard you with the word of God. God said, I am the head. I'm blessed in the city. I'm going to bring your foot down.
Bring it down.
Bring it down.
Bring it down.
But see, we ain't persistent.
No, sir.
The last thing is persistence and patience. You ain't persistent enough. We lazy sometimes. You can't travail in prayer because you only pray one time. Because the fort is still there, you give up and go home. But you got to prevail in the spirit. Oh God, you got to keep hitting that thing. Anybody ever hit a big cinder block? You got to keep hitting it. You got to keep hitting it. And after a while, it'll get a crack in it. That means it's getting weak. When you get a crack in it, that don't mean give up and go home. That means keep hitting it. Keep hitting it. I'm weak, but I'm going to keep on hitting. I'm going to keep hitting. I'm going to bump off. Oh, God, devil, you don't want to praise me because you have afflicted my body. But guess what? I'm going to praise you. I'm going to praise God. I learned no matter how I feel, I can come in to church and I'm tired. I can even approach my hour of prayer and I'm tired. It ain't about me being tired. It's about getting to the presence of God. It's a fullness of joy. God will speak to you. You gotta have some determination.
That's right.
You pray.
Yes, sir.
You done found out the stronghold.
Uh-huh.
And when you focus on it, the enemy, when you have discovered his fault, he makes a concentrated effort to defend his fort. You got to be willing to take whatever the enemy throws at you. Oh God, when you realize your children start acting up. My God, when he got a stronghold in your finance, anybody ever had, money trouble, really bad money trouble, where you can't keep $20? I'm talking about you got $700 today. Next week it's gone. You can't figure it out. Baby, you seen them receipts. What happened to devil got a stronghold. You won't do what you were supposed to do.
Uh-huh.
With your money.
That's right.
So he's fighting you. You allowed him. That's ground you've given up.
Gave up the ground.
You gave up the ground.
That's fine.
But guess what? Your understanding got to come open. And so that's all right, devil. I realize what I've done. I realize the error of my ways. And one of the main things I didn't do, I didn't put God first. Oh God, I didn't acknowledge God. I would come into the office, I would go over to Walmart, and I would maybe spend $200. And I'd come to the church and only pay $5. I didn't do God right. Oh God, the church need to raise money, and I'm hardly paying. I didn't do right. That's why you built up a stronghold in my finances. But guess what? Your stronghold is coming down. It's coming down. God says, bring your tithes and your offerings into the storehouse, and I'll bless you. Oh God, I mean, your blessings will overtake you. So guess what? You start bringing your tithes. You start bringing your offerings. So guess what's going to happen? Oh God, your light bill may be due. Your car may break down. That's the devil resisting you. Right. Yeah. Remember, he ain't fighting. He's trying to hold on to that soul.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
You got to give up.
Yes, sir.
You got to retreat.
That's right.
I got to give up this money. Yes.
Hallelujah.
You got to fight.
You got to fight.
That's the devil.
You don't believe it, but it's the truth.
That's the devil.
Hallelujah.
Because you're attacking the
show.
Go ahead.
Nice. You bring it down.
Yes, sir.
When the enemy fought has fallen, he got to retreat.
Jesus.
Search and destroy. I am more than a conqueror. I'm not only content in taking this stronghold, whatever stronghold that you've got, I'm coming forward. You're not going to stay right here. I'm taking everything.
Go ahead.
I'm taking it back.
Yes, sir.
Your hand,
Jesus. Glory to God.
Thank you, Lord.
You can't be. People ain't gonna understand you. Mm-hmm. Huh? If your wife ain't spiritual, she ain't gonna understand.
No, sir.
Amen.
Amen. Baby, why you gonna pay that? You know. You know we got to do this. Huh? But you got to know, huh? And you got to believe this, thanks to God.
Amen.
That my Father owns the cattle on the thousand hills. I believe God so strong. God will have a millionaire write you a check and don't know why he wrote it. Because God has blessed you. Huh? He don't know why he blessed you.
That's right.
Huh? That's why I walk with my chest out.
Right.
Not that I'm big.
Uh-huh.
Because I the God I serve.
Yes.
Don't worry about these materials. And God will provide.
He will.
Do what he says.
Yes.
Follow my word.
Yes.
And when the enemy kicks up, my God, you got to be willing to be ridiculed.
Yes.
See, you know, I used to be one of them people person. No. Want everybody to like me.
Uh-huh. Want
everybody to like me.
Come on.
You know, I'll never forget something my dad told me. As soon as I got saved, son, everybody ain't gonna like
it.
I kept trying to figure out why.
Why?
I always do good people.
Right.
I give you the shirt on my back if I see that. But I found out, boy, everybody ain't gonna like you.
No, right.
One thing about it, they do like they did, Joseph, because you got the favor on you, they will hate you.
Yeah.
They will hate you.
Yeah.
Without a cause, they just hate you. You never did anything. But what in your life? You can't dwell on that hatred. You got to walk in the favor of God. And then when the enemy rises up, just realize that God has given you the power to subdue the enemy. My God reminded of the story of King David. My God, when he came to the town of Ziklag, my God, it was a city. And the enemy had came in and sacked.
the king. Everybody looked at David. Yeah. My God, with everything going good, everybody happy with you, God.
Yeah.
But when things turn bad, you the one. You the reason why they done stole the women and the children. And they even talked about stoning David. Oh God, look at how the people turned against him. People will turn against you. Oh God, when the battle gets thick, God, they'll turn against you. But you can't trust in people. You got to trust in God. If you want to fall away, I'll miss you. But I'm going to
trust in God.
They talked about stoning David.
Yeah.
We have to stone him.
Yeah.
Oh God. No doubt David was troubled. But somewhere in you, every child of God, there has to be a fight in you. You can't be willing to let the enemy run off with your stuff. You can't let the enemy run ransack through your life.
Man.
And my God, David got over there. He had encouraged himself. And he sought the Lord. You got to seek God. Because God is the only one that's undefeated.
Amen.
God is the only one that's able to overcome everything.
Yes.
Oh God, when he sought the Lord, he said, Lord, should I pursue these truths? And the Lord says, pursue. You're going to overtake and you're going to recover all. You got to be willing and take boldness to go back and take what the enemy has stolen from you. You got to have some boldness. Give it back.
Give it back.
Give it back. It ain't yours. You got to have boldness.
Amen.
Praise God.
David went back and took everything. Took it back. You took it and won't yours. When God is with you, he's more than the world against you. You got to believe this thing. You got to say it enough to you believe it in your spirit. So people are going to fight you.
Amen. That's right.
Now, God said, the Bible says, you are more than a conqueror.
That's right.
You're not just limited to conquering.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. More than a conqueror, you're also a liberator.
Yes.
Huh?
Liberator.
Huh? Not only do you conquer, but you liberate.
Amen.
When the United States went in, they went in World War II. They liberated Paris from the thrones of the enemy.
Oh,
my God. The scripture says, Jesus said, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and to recover the sight to the blind, to bind up the brokenhearted, to set at liberty to them that are bruised. You don't have to be a preacher, my God, to set somebody free. See, people got it all wrong. Everybody want to preach. Everybody want to preach the gospel. But everybody can't preach the gospel.
That's right.
The gospel ain't the only thing that set people free. The Bible says they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. Just your testimony has the ability to set people free. You got to be able to testify and say, I was once bound by the same thing that had you bound. But God came in and set me free.
Whoa.
My God, you struggle with that thing now. But God delivered me from that same thing on a Saturday night on September the 25th, 1997. God came in and set me free. He delivered me. And the same God that delivered me, he can deliver you.
Amen.
It's your testimony. Why do you think the devil don't want you to testify? Because your struggle, people share your same struggle.
Yeah, that's right.
Struggle with the flesh. Oh God, I might have struggled. But God brought me out.
He did.
You can't be ashamed of this thing. But see, the devil wants you to have shame. But see, they don't need to be shamed because God delivered me from it. And you can't hold that against me. That was my past. It ain't my future. It was my past. It ain't my future. It was my past. It was a stronghold. And I brought it down. I subdued it. Because I'm more than a conqueror. When you conquer something,
yes,
you got under your subjection.
Yeah.
Huh?
Right.
When you conquer another nation, they got your influence.
That's right.
They got to carry your laws. Because you conquered it. My God, so nobody can't throw up nothing that was in your past.
Okay.
So that's what the enemy do. He wants you on a guilt trip.
Yes.
Oh, my God. But see, we can boldly enter the throne of grace. Because God, He's already delivered us. And your testimony is what set people free. Because the same thing that you hide, God had that. That's going to be your ministry.
That's right.
Amen.
Huh? Same thing. So you got to get the shame out. I ain't ashamed. Because God has set me free.
Amen.
More than a conqueror.
Yes.
You gotta say, I'm more than a conqueror. Listen, I'm more than a conqueror.
More than a conqueror.
If I get in a fight, I aim to win. I'm not beating that hard either. Anybody ever been in a fight in their life? And when I hit you, I want you to feel it.
Uh-huh.
When you hit the enemy, you need to let him feel it. Because I'm coming to tell you, beloved, the fight is real. My God, have anybody ever been sitting around doing nothing? Then all of a sudden, someone will descend on you like a heaviness.
Yeah.
Huh? Yeah. Out of nowhere. Huh? And you're like, what the devil? But see, in the past, that might have got me. Because I wasn't strong enough. I wasn't sensitive enough. But then I learned out that I'm doing something. I'm doing something in the kingdom of God. That's why the devil fight me. So guess what? When that spirit descends on me, I'll break it off of me. I'll walk. I get the spirit and I'll prevail. And then say, he teaches me to walk.
Yes, he does.
You gotta learn how to fight.
Yes, sir.
Pray.
There's a reason why the heaven is spirit on you. You got to know it's attacking
it.
And I'm going to tell you, the enemy is working some stuff. And if you don't fight, some stuff going to get all messed up. And you could have prevented it. God will let you know it. He lets you sense it so you can defeat it. And if you be lazy if you want to, something will happen. And you could have stopped it. Somebody, let me tell you how serious it is.
Go ahead.
People are connected to you.
Yes. Talk about it.
And they can be getting ready to get into something.
Yep.
It may take their life.
Yep.
Huh? God showed me about intercession.
Wow.
He said, people, lives are dependent on you. You ain't got time to mess around.
That's right. Preach. Preach.
You got to pray.
Yeah.
When I tell you to pray, you got to pray.
Yeah.
You got to pray.
Pray.
People, life you can save.
Uh-huh.
But because you're lazy, they're gone.
Yeah.
God lets you spiritual so you can save them.
Amen.
You can't be selfish.
That's right.
You can't be lazy.
That's right. Because
when God speaks, God will say fast.
Yes,
he will.
Lord, if you want to,
uh-huh.
Something to come down the pipe, you could have prevented.
Amen.
But I learned. So I learned that when I can come into a room. And my God, God is sharpening your senses so much that my God, you ain't got to open your mouth. But I can feel you fighting. Oh God, but see, you got to realize that you and Satan are mortal enemies.
Jesus.
Why do you think the fight is so strong? We got children, another generation that's looking at us. We can't afford to drop the ball right now.
Amen.
We got innocent children that you can't be lazy in your prayer life. But that's the only thing that's going to bring down the walls of the enemy. It's prayer. But guess what? Because you won't pray, God will give you a Pharaoh to make you pray. Let me tell you, we in a praying time now. If you don't have a relationship with God, you better get one.
Amen.
It's going to get rough. It's going to get tougher. God going to separate those that are really doing right and those that ain't doing right.
Amen.
Those that are faking it and those that are doing the real deal, God going to separate.
Amen.
Because destruction is coming on the land. People are going to be running. They're looking all right now, but guess what? In their mind, they're scared. They're uncertain. One lady said her child told her that she's scared
Her baby says she's scared because her trunk is open. And let me tell you, that man is wicked. You can believe everything you want to. He got money, and he's wicked. You got a Republican Congress. You got a Republican Senate. Oh, my God. Things are going to get rough. But if you believe in God, God said, I'll open up the windows of heaven, and I'll pour you out a blessing. It don't matter who in office. But if you serve God, God will make a way for you. What you need, bitch? It don't matter if you don't like me. It don't matter if you hate me because I'm black. But I learned to believe the word of God. God said,
my God, God will bless you. He'll bless you. If you do what you're supposed to do, God will bless you. And even the people that you thought was your friend, they'll begin to hate you because the blessings of God are showing up the enemy. It'll show them up better. It'll get hot.
Exposes the servant. Yes, if you can't stand to see me bless you, a servant.
That's right.
You can't stand the glory of God on it. You're a servant.
Go ahead.
As God begin to bless me, you see I'm crowned up. You're a servant. You got enemies. You got strikes. You cannot stop me. They can't celebrate you.
Amen.
They hated you all along. They were just hiding.
That's all.
They thought they were better than
all.
I'm
doing
better. I'm doing
better.
It don't matter.
Reach.
But the minute you start.
Reach.
Getting up.
Yeah, yeah.
We gonna get up. Come on now.
Say it.
Reach.
He done got too big.
Uh-huh.
He done changed.
Change.
I changed. I'm the same one.
Yep.
You're just walking into your blessing.
Yes. Speak true.
You were fine when I was struggling. You were fine.
Yep.
But see, the thing is about it, let me show you, Pastor. You celebrate them.
Uh-huh.
But then they can't celebrate you.
Yeah.
But see, that's hate.
Hey.
But I learned, it may hurt the flesh, but I learned to let you go. I'm not going to chase after you. Because God will do some things for his own good. God will try to separate you from
that's
people
right.
to let you
that's
know
right.
they can't walk
that's
with you
right.
in their blessed place. I might have used them for a season
right.
to bless you, but they're not worthy of the blessing that I'm going to give to you.
Right.
You got to learn to kiss them and tell them goodbye.
Yeah.
Goodbye. See ya.
Yeah.
Wouldn't want to be ya.
Because
God is still with me.
Yeah.
I'm still blessed.
Yeah.
On my conquest, to tear down the strongholds of the enemy. Every place he got an encampment, I'm going to tear it down.
That's right.
When you got the boldness,
you preaching, man.
The enemy, he feed you.
Yes, sir.
Because you ain't
fighting.
You learn how to fight. The main ingredient is your prayer life.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Amen.
Prayer.
Uh-huh.
You don't have one? You better get one.
Better get one.
Huh? You ain't gonna make it. I learned, don't try to talk out, talk it out. Pray about it.
That's right. That's right.
You learn to drive. I can go talk to him. How many have tried that?
Yep, I tried it.
Well, no matter what you say is the wrong thing. And you leave the situation worse than what it was.
Pray.
Pray about it.
Yes.
And watch God work on your behalf. Pray about it.
Amen.
You got a stronghold on your job? Pray about it.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Pray about it.
Yes.
You gotta go over front nobody.
Amen.
Put them in prayer.
Yes. That's right.
That's the secret.
Amen.
Huh?
Yes.
That's prayer has a power. To bring down governments.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes,
it does.
And I bet You had a whole lot of people praying for the devil for their Castro.
Yes, sir.
If you looked at the news, it was a mixed response.
Yes, sir.
In Cuba, they were kind of mourning. They were scared. I don't know what's going to happen next. But in Havana and over in Miami, they were celebrating. They were saying that this man had killed many of their husbands. Anybody that spoke against the government, he killed
them. I heard the squad.
You got to learn, the weapons of our warfare are not common.
Man, the mighty through God.
You ain't going to conquer the enemy with a sword. You're not going to conquer the enemy with a rifle. As natural military do. You conquer the enemy through prayer mixed with the word of God.
Amen.
God's word is a shoe. A surety. That's why the preachers tell you to study. You can't depend on the preacher. You got to know the word of God for yourself. You got to know what his promises says concerning you.
That's right.
If God, if you listen, God, if you told me, I will be blessed. God, if you said, if I paid my tithes and if I paid my offering, you said you would do this for me. You open the window of heaven, you pull me out of the... Put that word before God.
Yes.
Huh? He hastens to respond to his word.
Yes.
He hastens. See, you got to learn the word of God. Put that word before God. God, I've done this. You got to have expectancy. God, I expect you to bless me. I expect you to show up. Because I'm mixed prayer. With the word of God. And watch these strongholds come down.
Amen.
Watch them come down. Can't be scared to confront them. Huh? Whatever place you got in camp, get it.
Get it.
Put the word of God on it.
Yes.
Pray on it. And watch it come down.
Amen.
In my conclusion, remember, you are more than a conqueror.
Amen.